Physicians and staff must feel safe when they come to this hospital. It is also important that the patients feel safe. The relationship the staff have with patients is a very important factor related to safety.
We provide the highest level of care, the most complex level of care for people with severe illnesses. Some of our patients and clients are individuals who've had severe trauma in childhood, they've been in foster care experiences, they've had abuse experiences throughout their young lives, and they end up in more challenging circumstances in adulthood, which lead to more complex services they find themselves in.
Our patients, they're in trauma. They've had the worst day of their life, and you're helping them to get to the next day. So you really just need to be aware of the seriousness of that.
When a patient lashes out or behaves aggressively, there's a combination of factors happening. One is the mental illness itself. Secondly, there's their history of trauma, which is very frequent in our environments. And then perhaps they may have a substance use disorder that's impacting them.
Therapeutic and Relational Security, or C-Think Act, it's one of the significant investments that we've put into staff development here at the hospital. C-Think Act, or Therapeutic and Relational Security, is really about the staff recognizing and understanding their environment and understanding our patients' needs.
An example could be if a patient is asking for something and the staff member says no. And the staff member may have a really good reason for saying no. It may be something that is creating a risk. And it's how they say no and how they manage that interaction with the patient around the no. Perhaps there's an offering of something different or another alternative. Perhaps there's an opportunity to be distracted or given an activity, or perhaps there's a conversation that's de-escalating in nature. But it's understanding that there are certain factors that trigger patients. We chose the C-Think Act because it is an evidence-based approach that has been implemented across the UK. And the UK has about 55 hospitals that are forensic. So we felt that of all the places globally that are doing work in this area, they are the most advanced with using this relational security approach across their hospitals. So when I talk about trauma-informed practice and minimizing coercion, enhancing choice and collaboration, I'm really talking about removing those triggers wherever possible that cause a person to feel that trauma history coming up in themselves.
I see people stepping away from the way that we've always done something and acknowledging that there's perhaps another way to look at it, a different lens, which is extremely encouraging.
The bottom line of why we introduced therapeutic and relational security is that it achieves a number of goals. It helps us keep everybody safe. It gives us a thorough knowledge of how our patients are and who they are and what they need to do to move forward with their lives in as safe a way as possible.
And I think that people are beginning to feel hopeful that change is happening and it's possible here. And they're starting to engage differently in initiatives like relational security and are wanting to invest in their practice and the organization differently because of it.